New Jersey becomes the most recent state to legalize physician-assisted suicide for terminally ill patients. Governor Phil Murphy, a Democrat and lifelong Catholic, signed the legislation Friday. He says he wrestled with the decision to sign. He says the law, quote, best respects the freedom and humanity of all New Jersey residents. Join me now to talk more about the broader implications of this is Dennis Poust, Director of Communications for the New York State Catholic Conference. He joins me now by Skype from Albany. Dennis, welcome into the broadcast. Attention now turns to your state of New York, where the governor is considering similar legislation to legalize physician-assisted suicide. This issue, as you know, is often portrayed as individual choice, but what are the larger repercussions on society, especially for those most vulnerable?
Well, yeah, that's a really good point because it's always portrayed. That's how the advocates portray it, as people's individual right, and it doesn't hurt anybody, and it's an individual right. But it goes to how we as a society see the end of life, and it has serious repercussions in terms of what will the future hold for. We've already seen in Canada and California and elsewhere health agencies and insurance companies offering suicide pills rather than home care or rather than experimental treatment. What will it mean for people with disabilities? Will they be urged to get out of the way? Because frankly, that's why people often say that they want to choose assisted suicide, this fear of being not useful to society, being a burden. And we know people with disabilities fear that they will be pressured or coerced to end their lives early. So it has repercussions throughout all of society, not just to the individual.
As you know, New York Governor Andrew Cuomo is on board with it. What do you think the pushback will be like at the state Senate and the assembly level?
Well, frankly, the governor is following the lead of the Senate and assembly, actually. There have been bills here for years. They haven't gone anywhere. We've had a Republican Senate that hasn't really considered it, but the Democratic Assembly hasn't really either. Now it's a one-party state beginning this year, which is why you've seen the abortion expansion bill and other legislation. So the governor has said they should pass the bill. That's the first time he's ever said anything about it, but that gives impetus to it. It gives some momentum, which is not a good thing for the movement. You know, the proponents want to show this air of inevitability for assisted suicide. We know that's not the case. Maryland recently defeated a bill. Connecticut recently defeated a bill in committee when they didn't have the votes. But Governor Cuomo has shown the ability to get things done, whether we're talking about same-sex marriage or abortion expansion or any number of things. And so it's troubling to see him come out in favor of it.
Well, it's such an important issue. And like I say, it's hard for so many people to think about, but it is important that we stay on top of this. And so we appreciate your analysis. Dennis Poust, Director of Communications for the New York State Catholic Conference. Thanks so much for your time today.
Thanks, Wyatt. My pleasure.